Hi, it's T with Teaquilts, and I can't even remember where I last left off on my spiderweb block quilt. So what you're seeing here is a photo that I posted on Facebook and Instagram where I was asking members of those groups to let me know which setting they preferred. It was a lot of people for the left and a lot of people for the right, so it was kind of even as far as preference. I think the left side actually won, but as I continued to look at these blocks, I decided to go with the right setting, because I liked the way that the spider webs were kind of elongated and it gave it a different pattern. And since it was so scrappy, I thought that it kind of grounded it a little better. Whereas on the left, it just looked like, it still looks like some spider webs, but I feel like you've got to look for them a little bit more. And this is actually going to be my setting. So I am going to start sewing these blocks into rows. And I'm gonna turn the camera, which is gonna be strange for my video, but I just want to show you that I'm kind of do left-handed type things. When I sew rows together, you see how you would normally sew, you would take your right side and put on the left side, and so you'd be sewing all of these down, and then I would leave it connected and then add the third piece on, and then I would leave it connected and add the fourth piece on. Then what happens at the end is I have all of these rows, 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, that I have to sew across. So what I do is, I'm going to turn you now, is I put my short rows together. So I will stack this row on top of this row, go down and get all of the shorter pieces on first. So I would be doing, adding, you know, these rows on as I go. And then when I get through, all I've got to do is sew down the 1, 2, and 3 instead of 5 shorter ones, 3 longer ones. So I know that's a little weird, but I just thought I would do that. Sometimes I think it's a left-handedness thing, but it doesn't really matter which way you do it. Just get it done. But that's what I'm gonna work on, and then I'll come back when I have the completed top. So I decided to come back and show you what I've done. I've actually sewn my quilt top together as far as the rows, connecting them, and I'm gonna go up close because I'm actually holding the camera today and want you to see that in between here I've got connecting threads. And what I did was started at the bottom. I took the bottom row as my row 1, here is my row 2, and so I put them together by sewing continuously down each row. Then when I got through, I came back and added these blocks on, these blocks here on, and then continued all the way up. And so instead of having to sew 1, 2, 3, 4, 5 rows across this way, I have 3 rows that I'll sew the whole entire length. I am probably going to clip my threads here, just so that I can make it easier for me to press my seams. And then I am going to sew these 2 sets of seams, these 2 sets, and then put the piece together. Okay, I'm back with my completed quilt top. And since this is not really gonna be a major project, I am thinking that I am not going to put any borders on this. I'm just going to make it an actual quilt top. So I'm going to just put it in my to be quilted pile. And it will become something that I will use in my lectures, just to show how to use some scraps. But I do like the setting that I chose because of the elongation through the center. And if you really look hard, you can see, like, through the stars, you can see
like one big round circle, and I kind of like that effect too. And then that same circle intersects with the bottom circle. So I'm glad I chose this setting, and I was just playing around with this die just to see what it could do. So thank you all so much for watching, and I will see you in my next video. Bye bye, everybody.